Hey YouTube, today I'm about to present to you 2021 brand spanking new Mazda 6. In this video I'm going to show you the interior as well as the exterior of this car. And so guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine, let on for a while. Lock on lock and of course charm button. Also aftermarket alarm with remote start, very convenient feature indeed. Ultra long range as you can see, not bad. Beautiful exterior color and night on the trims. Absolutely gorgeous Japanese princess. Look at this beauty. Smart key access system. The mirrors fold in and fold out upon locking and unlocking. Pull out the car, press this button. And to unlock, press once again. Very simple. The light wide open doors, sounds like 90 degrees. Easy entry and exit, of course. Black leather interior. This car has, I believe, 8 airbags. Perforated seats. Also, as an option, an upper trim, a cooled. Crisp design, fully wrapped steering wheel, modified control side to side. Alrighty, guys, let's hop in. The car is front wheel drive. 2 liter. It produces 150 horsepower inline 460 valve, Sky Active G technology. Fuel economy is just amazing, a lot of torque. Manual tilt and telescopic steering column, very convenient. High quality leather, it's all plastic, it's not metal as you can see. Notice that engine, put foot on brake and then the button stop. It's quite easy, as you can see, very quiet engine indeed. Love it. Infotainment screen, dual zone, fully automatic climate control. Alrighty guys, this car has automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers. Right now, let's turn headlight, fog lights, high beams, search lights right there. Power exterior mirrors, use this joystick to adjust left and right, up and down, also heated. And of course, power folding function, very nice. Automatic mode, power window lock. All 4 windows in this car fully automatic in both directions, up and down. Nice. Alrighty guys, right now let's open the hood and take a look at the exterior of this car. Fuel tank. This car missing power moonroof. As you can see, back wheels fully tinted, chrome axle frames, excellent coefficient on track, fuel cap, premium on the fuel only, of course. Full LED taillights, dual polished exhaust pipes, rear parking assist, of course. Top up, Scat G, a lot of chrome, LED license plate lights, and rear view camera, like anyway. Rear defrosted glass, of course, and third brake light right there. Mold is quite absolutely gorgeous. Arms, Bridgestone turns the tires, 19-inch 225/45 front ventilated disc brakes, and rear also ventilated disc brakes. Alrighty guys, so now I'm going to show you underneath on this car. LED intercepted exterior mirrors, very bright, and there is no welcome lights. VIN number, lamp head. LED headlights, projector, lot of power, lap washers right there, and front parking assist. Huge huge Mazda emblem. Independent McPherson stress suspension with Android on the front and molten suspension out back. Fantastic. Main rivals for this vehicle is a Toyota Camry, Honda Accord, of course Nissan Tiana, VW Passat, Skoda Superb, and maybe Chevy Malibu and Ford Mondeo. Same smoky access system on this side. Now I'll show you the rear suspension of this beautiful vehicle. Rear fog light. Alrighty guys, right now, take a good look at the exterior, let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part of this vehicle. Chrome, of course aluminum, solid plastic, high gloss black finish, soft leather and armrest. This portion is stitching, as you can see, speakers, your tweeters right there, storage area, and LED illumination, as you can see, very bright. Very nice attention to the details. Storage compartment over the driver. Turn off the parking sensors. Traction stabilization, eye stop off. Memory seats, two-person memory, lumbar support, sliding, seat high, upper portion, low portion, and recline. That's it. Very plush, comfortable seats. Tire pressure, 225/45 inch. Not bad. Force your pedals. Alrighty guys. Let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Very nice. Heads up display right there. As you can see. Easy to read gauges, of course, information right there, average and current fuel economy, trip A, trip B, range, as you can see, easy to use. See control buttons, you can increase and decrease the volume, voice commands.
Say a command.
Help.
At any time, you can skip voice guidance by pressing the talk button or cancel it by pressing the hang up button. Available commands are entertainment, communication, navigation, settings, applications, and favorites. Always available are go back, cancel, main menu, help, and tutorial. Please wait until after the beep before saying a command. Say a command.
Cancel. That's pretty much it for this voice commands. Unhook and off buttons for a telephone, via Bluetooth you can connect your telephone and receive calls basically, and Bluetooth streaming of audio, I believe. your paddle shifters, 6-speed or automatic transmission, minus for the downshift, plus for the upshift, cruise control settings and speed limiter, quite easy. Of course, your wiper controls and light indicator controls, intermittent wiper controls right there, stitching right there, absolutely amazing. Very nice stage, the details. Dual zone fully automatic climb control, your fan speed right there, quite easy to use. Air conditioning on off, recycle, sync, you can control both sides. Individual settings, 3 defrost, 4 defrost, different modes, heated seats, 3 stage, high, medium, low, and off for the driver and for the passenger. It's quite easy. And heated steering wheel, awesome. CD, eject right there, some storage compartment, shift lock release, sport mode. Alright. Rear view camera with guidance lines, as you can see. And of course, you can adjust brightness, contrast, color, reset. Graphic and resolution is not so good, in my opinion. Plus for the upshift, manual shifting, and minus for downshift. That's it. Can increase and decrease volume, electronic parking brake with auto fall function. To engage it, just pull and to disengage, put your foot on brake and then press on it. It's quite easy. Alright, let's see your applications. Fuel economy monitor, as you can see. Your vehicle status, low fuel, alright. Maintenance. Then, of course, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Entertainment. It's pretty much self-explanatory, as you can see. Different settings. Communication. Nope. Navigation right now is not available. Only compass, latitude, longitude. Elevation and settings for the system, basically. As you can see, display. Then safety. Sound. Clock adjustment, GPS synchronization, vehicle, devices, and basically your system. That's it. And your favorites, my button. Of course, two cup holders, a little shade right there, soft leather wrap center console, your power supply, power socket, SD card, plus to USB and auxiliary search, not bad. Auto dim rear mirror, sunglass container, it's also padded, illumination, SOS emergency roadside assistance, sun visors, vent mirror with illumination, car holder, handles, all handles. With my 6'3" stature, those seats are just amazing. Very good visibility, quite sensitive brakes, sharp steering, extremely reliable Mazda 6. It's just what you expect from this vehicle, at least. Awesome vehicle. And panel dim, you can just panel dim right there, quite easy. Right now, let's shut it down. All right, let's check back seats, shall we? My 6'3" stature is quite easy to get in and out. Ergonomically, it's very nice, put together everything right there. Alrighty, back seats. Child safety locks, of course, right there. This mechanism, it's all metal right there. High gloss black finish. Stitching, double stitching, the materials they carry over, ISOFIX system, chest anchors, periphery seats, the adjustable headrests, as you can see. Not bad. But my 6'3" stature is quite easy to get in and out. Of course, rear vents, storage compartment, and even your central armrest with two cup holders, heated seats, 3-stage, some storage compartment, also pad, and 2 USB integration to charge your device. Rear visibility is pretty good. Cut hook, side curtain airbags, and illumination up top. Awesome. Beautiful Mazda 6 interior. just a beauty indeed. Legroom's not an issue at all. Headroom is pretty good. Showroom's okay. Let's check trunk space, 492 liters. The fuel tank is around 62 liters combined. Fuel consumption for this car is around 6.5 liters per 100 kilometer. Fold in receipts, aftermarket alarm, remote start, controlled via your apps, your smartphone, some storage compartment, and right there, spare tire, 185.55 6 inch, not bad. It's not a donut. It's not a temporary spare tire. One convenient handle to close trunk lid. Awesome. Absolutely gorgeous vehicle in my opinion. Same LED illumination right there, very bright. Very nice attention to the details. Power adjustment for the passenger seat, minus lumbar support, and of course memory seats. Glove box is not lockable, as you can see, but it's damp. Here's your manuals, wrapped in leather, not bad. This generation, the Mazda 6, is just stunning, inside and out. Beautiful car. Alrighty guys, hope you enjoy my first in-depth tour this beautiful 2021 Mazda 6. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, for subscribing, truly appreciate it. Take care guys.